Hi everyone, long time no see, sorry for the delay. University's been a nightmare and my family's been blissfully ignorant of my struggles. But enough about my melodramatic existence, let's dive into the video.
Dobby, now lounging on the couch, chuckled. This is better than TikTok. Go on, Midoriya, tell us more about your nun life. Midoriya, exasperated, glanced at Bakugo. Can we just get through breakfast? Fine, but if anyone so much as breathes wrong, I'm throwing them out. Isn't this my house? So, I could ask the landlord to kick you out, too. I know almost 90% of landlords here. What are you, the population record tracker? For me, he sounded more like a stalker. As they moved to the kitchen, the chaos continued. Shigaraki kept making snide comments, Dobby found everything hilarious, and Toga alternated between apologizing and laughing. Over breakfast, Bakugo tried to focus. Eat quickly. We've got a lot to do today. Midoriya nodded, shoveling food into his mouth. Right, Shigaraki, leaning back in his chair, smirked. So, what's on the agenda for today, Father Bakugo? Bakugo glared at him. None of your business. Just keep your nose out of it. Shigaraki laughed. Sure. Just here to observe. After breakfast, Bakugo and Midoriya headed back to their room, with Shigaraki and Dobby trailing behind like annoying shadows. Bakugo growled. Don't you two have somewhere else to be? Nope. Midoriya sighed, trying to keep his composure. Just ignore them, Kachan. Easier said than done. He pushed Midoriya inside the bathroom and handed him a bottle of strange-smelling liquid. Here, put this on. We need to mask your scent. Midoriya took the bottle, wrinkling his nose at the smell. What type of liquid is this? This stuff reeks, Kachan. Bakugo smirked. You wouldn't want to know. Better than getting caught by demons. Now hurry up. Midoriya reluctantly applied the liquid, trying to cover every inch of his skin. Ugh, I feel like a walking perfume factory. Shigaraki peeked through the bathroom's window from outside and snickered. You two are quite the pair. This is better than TV. Bakugo shot him a glare. Are you AF King Stalker? Oi, Toga, kick this bastard out of this house. Shigaraki, come here. You can't just peek through someone's window. Especially a bathroom's window. It's an exception when I'm doing a job. I will send you to the heavens if you keep bullshitting me with your stupid job. Midoriya, trying to lighten the mood, joked, maybe we should charge him for the entertainment. Toga laughed, I'd pay. This is pure gold, haha, or rather I'll become a valuable fossil once Bakugo buried me alive. She looked at Bakugo, mortified with his deadly expression. You guys should start a YouTube channel. Demons and Nuns, The Misadventures. I'd subscribe. Dobby, lounging on the bed, grinned, earning an eye roll from Bakugo. Come on, Deku, let's get out of here before I lose my mind. As they made their way out of their room, Shigaraki and Dobby followed, much to Bakugo's annoyance. You really don't have anything better to do. Nope, Midoriya sighed, it's going to be a long day. Bakugo realized that Shigaraki was expecting them to leave the apartment since it's already daytime. He immediately thought of an excuse. Hey, Deku, why don't we just stay inside today? It's safer, and we can keep an eye on these idiots. Midoriya blinked, he knew the play pretend was still ongoing to not give his identity away to Shigaraki. That included the fact that Bakugo was protecting him from the sun. Stay inside, what are we going to do all day? Shigaraki perked up, Roblox, ever played? Bakugo looked incredulous, still pretending. Seriously, we're going to waste a day playing a kid's game? Shigaraki smirked. You got a better idea. Plus, it'll keep us entertained and out of trouble. Midoriya, intrigued, nodded. I guess it couldn't hurt. Plus, I've never played Roblox before. Dobby laughed. This I've got to see. Bakugo, raging over Roblox. Reluctantly, Bakugo agreed. Fine, but no one tells anyone about this. They set up in the living room, Toga bringing out her laptop and phones. Here, everyone grab a device. Let's get this party started. As they logged into Roblox, Shigaraki took it upon himself to teach Midoriya the ropes. Okay, Deku, first thing you need to know is how to navigate. And try not to die immediately. Midoriya laughed, quickly getting into the game. Got it, this is kind of fun. Shigaraki, sitting closer to Midoriya, leaned over to help him with the controls. Here, let me show you this trick. Bakugo, watching from the side, grumbled. Why are you sitting so close to him, Shigaraki? Shigaraki glanced at Bakugo and smirked. Jealous much, Bakugo? Bakugo's eye twitched. As if, just don't get too comfortable. Midoriya, feeling the tension, tried to lighten the mood. Hey, Kachan, join us in this quest. We could use your skills. Bakugo grudgingly agreed, joining the game. Despite himself, he found it surprisingly fun, even if he wouldn't admit it. Shigaraki and Midoriya continued to get closer, laughing and joking as they played. Shigaraki showed Midoriya all the tricks, and they even teamed up on a few quests, their shoulders occasionally brushing. Dabi, noticing Bakugo's growing irritation, couldn't help but tease. You okay there, Bakugo? You look a little tense. I'm fine, just focusing on the game. Midoriya, catching the tension, tried to include Bakugo more. Kachan, you're really good at this. How did you figure out that move? Bakugo, trying to suppress his annoyance, mumbled, just a lot of practice. As the day went on, the tension between Bakugo and Shigaraki grew. Shigaraki kept finding excuses to be close to Midoriya, and Bakugo's patience was wearing thin. At one point, Shigaraki leaned in to whisper something to Midoriya, their faces just inches apart. Do you have to be so damn close? Shigaraki smirked, pulling back slightly but still close enough to annoy Bakugo. Relax, Bakugo, we're just friends, for now. You know nuns can't have romantic relationships, right? Shigaraki's mood suddenly gloomed. I can make him change his mind. Dabi stretched, his versus line getting exposed. Well, that was unexpectedly fun. Who knew Roblox and tea could be so entertaining? Toga, finally giving up on trying to make Shigaraki leave, sighed. I guess you're staying for dinner too, huh? Shigaraki grinned. Wouldn't miss it. After dinner, Shigaraki finally left, giving them a huge relief. That was close. We almost got caught. That's because you're an idiot in making excuses. So it was my fault, mister. Yeah, you almost gave us away. In Class 2A's location. Hey, have you seen Todoroki? No, I haven't. He hasn't come back from his evening jog. Should we look for him? It's already 11 p.m. Seriously, let's go already. Not Iida panicking over Todoroki but is always chill as f when it comes to us peasants. I didn't mean to imply such things, Mineta. Sure, you didn't. Some of us should stay here so someone could tell us if in case Todoroki comes back. I'll stay, I've some homework to finish so. You've been doing that homework for 3 days now, Mineta. So, life ain't a race, dude. That doesn't apply to homeworks, man. The squad will go with Iida. Anyone else who wanna join? I'll stay here, I guess. It's not like I'm not concerned or anything, it's just there's a new chapter of Blue Lock. So, only Mina, Kirishima, Siro, Kaminari, Uraraka, Jiro, Hagakuri, and Suyu are coming with me. Yeah, let's go already, Iida. Siro, chill, your man's okay, we're not dating, we're just two dudes, holding hands from time to time and cuddling to sleep once in a while. Siro blushed hard. Let's go find him before he gets into any danger. In the alternate world, hurry up you motherfuckers, you're slowing me down. Oh, just say you're worried that the sunrise will catch up to us and hurt your darling. Darling what bastard, I don't care if Deku die. Denial is a river in Egypt. Midoriya, seemingly oblivious to the tension, piped up. Kachan, I'm starving. Bakugo's eye twitched. Ha, you just ate before we left the brat's apartment. What else do you want? Midoriya looked sheepish. I don't know, I feel like I'm not getting full. What do, Kachan? I don't f-king know. Eat grass or something. Midoriya pouted. No way, why would you make me eat that? Bakugo rolled his eyes. I don't give a s what you eat. Just stop whining. Hey, now, let's not be too harsh on the poor boy. Maybe he just needs a little encouragement. Bakugo glared at him. Encouragement my ass, he's a damn glutton. Midoriya's eyes widened. Kachan, don't be so mean. I'm just hungry. Dabi laughed. Perhaps what he needs is a more balanced diet. Like, say, some protein. How about it, Bakugo? Share some of that macho strength of yours. Bakugo clenched his fists. You want me to punch you, bastard? Midoriya quickly intervened. No fighting, please. Kachan, can't we just find a place to eat? Fine, but if you don't shut up after this, I'm leaving your ass behind. Dabi laughed hard. Ah, young love, warms the heart, doesn't it? Bakugo's face turned even redder. You're dead, Dabi. Suddenly, they heard a rustling in the bushes, and Shoto Todoroki emerged, looking furious. Shoto, Midoriya exclaimed, eyes wide. What are you doing here? Shoto's eyes narrowed. I've been looking for you, Izuku. I thought something bad happened to you, so I started searching. I'm right, you're actually caught by this shameless priest.
Bakugo, immediately on guard, stepped in front of Midoriya.
What do you want, half and half?
Shoto ignored Bakugo's hostility.
Let go of Izuku, now.
Like hell you're taking him anywhere.
Shoto's anger flared.
I won't let you hold him hostage any longer. Before anyone could react, Shoto unleashed a blast of ice, freezing the ground around them.
Bakugo and the others barely managed to dodge.
Bakugo, furious, charged at Shoto.
You're not taking him.
The forest erupted into chaos as they fought, Shoto's ice and fire clashing with Bakugo's explosions.
Dabi stood back, amused by the spectacle. Despite their best efforts, it quickly became clear that Shoto was too powerful for them to handle.
He managed to corner Midoriya, who looked torn between following Shoto and staying with his friends.
Izuku, we need to go. It's not safe here.
Bakugo, panting and covered in frost, glared at Shoto.
Don't you dare touch him.
Shoto's expression softened slightly.
Bakugo, I'm not going to be your enemy. But if you get in my way, I won't hesitate.
Midoriya, torn, looked between Bakugo and Shoto.
Kachan, what do we do?
Bakugo, teeth gritted, held Midoriya's hand tightly.
We fight, together.
Shoto, seeing Midoriya look back twice to Bakugo, felt his heart drop.
I didn't know you'd be able to betray me someday, Izuku.
Very well, then, but don't say I didn't warn you.
The forest floor trembled as the clash between Bakugo and Shoto reached its peak.
The air crackled with tension and energy, mixing the brilliance of Bakugo's exploding lights with the biting cold of Shoto's ice.
Bakugo's eyes burned with fury as he knocked an arrow to his bow, the light of the good spirit pulsing intensely.
He drew back the string and released, sending a streak of blinding light and
energy toward Shoto.
Shoto responded by conjuring a thick wall of ice to deflect the powerful blast.
Stay back, Izuku.
Bakugo roared, his voice cutting through the chaos. His gaze was fierce, every inch of him focused on Shoto.
I won't let you touch him.
Shoto, icy eyes locked on Bakugo, barely flinched as the light and explosions raged around him.
His expression was a mixture of frustration and determination.
Bakugo's jaw clenched, he stepped in front of Midoriya, who looked distressed and confused.
You think I'll just let you drag him off without a fight?
Think again. Shoto's eyes softened momentarily as he saw Bakugo's unwavering protection of Midoriya.
The sight stirred something deep within him, but he pushed it aside.
This isn't about you or me. It's about keeping Izuku safe.
As Shoto summoned a wall of ice to push Bakugo back, Bakugo leapt over it with explosive force.
He landed dangerously close to Shoto, their faces inches apart.
The proximity made the air between them thick with tension, both emotional and physical.
Safe from what?
From you.
Bakugo's voice was low and harsh, his breath hot against Shoto's cold skin.
You're the one causing all this mess.
Shoto's gaze flickered to Midoriya, who was still frozen in indecision.
He reached out a hand, his voice softer but no less urgent.
Izuku, please, we need to go, it's for your own good.
His heart raced, not just from fear but from the undeniable pull of the conflicting emotions around him.
Bakugo, seeing the struggle in Midoriya's eyes, felt a pang of desperation.
He moved even closer to Shoto, their bodies almost touching.
He knocked another arrow, the light of the good spirit shining fiercely.
Don't you see, he doesn't want to leave with you. He wants to stay here with me. And I'm not letting you take him.
The heat from Bakugo's exploding lights mixed with the chill from Shoto's ice, creating a storm of swirling heat and cold around them.
The intensity of the moment heightened the charged atmosphere between Bakugo and Shoto.
Shoto's hand twitched as if wanting to reach out to Bakugo, to break through the barrier of hostility between them.
His voice was strained with emotion.
Bakugo, I didn't want it to come to this. But if you won't let him go, I'll do whatever it takes.
Bakugo's eyes flared with a mix of anger and something else, something he couldn't quite name but that made his heart race in an entirely different way.
He met Shoto's gaze, the intensity of the fight turning into an unexpected, almost tangible connection.
Midoriya, watching the two of them, felt his own heart ache at the sight.
He knew he was caught in the middle of something far more complex than a simple fight.
The fight between Bakugo and Shoto reached a fever pitch.
The clash of Bakugo's explosive light and Shoto's biting cold filled the forest with a cacophony of sound and fury.
Despite Bakugo's desperate efforts to protect Midoriya, Shoto's sheer power and precision eventually overwhelmed him.
With a final blast of ice, Shoto knocked Bakugo off his feet. Bakugo hit the ground hard, breathless and battered. Shoto, panting and covered in frost, stood over him, eyes blazing with determination. You can't take him. Bakugo gasped, struggling to push himself up. Shoto's expression was a mix of sadness and resolve. I don't want to fight you, Bakugo. I'm just trying to protect Izuku. Just then, a figure emerged from the shadows, Dabi, smirking with an air of casual confidence. Seems like you're having a rough day, little brother. Dabi's voice dripping with sarcasm. Shoto's eyes narrowed, recognizing the familiar voice. Dabi, what are you doing here? Dabi shrugged nonchalantly. Oh, just thought I'd come see how my dear, lovely brother was doing. You know, the one who always had to be the golden child. Shoto's eyes flashed with anger. I don't have time for your games, Dabi. Dabi grinned. Games? I thought you'd never ask. He glanced at Bakugo. So, you think you're tough, huh? And here I was thinking this would be easy. But, hey, let's make it interesting. With a snap of his fingers, Dabi conjured an illusion. The air shimmered, and suddenly, a figure materialized, Endeavor, the powerful demon and Shoto's estranged father. The illusion was flawless, replicating every detail with eerie precision. Endeavor, Shoto's eyes widened, his focus wavering. Dabi's smirk widened. That's right, I thought a little family reunion might spice things up. After all, you're always so driven by daddy's approval. Shoto's eyes burned with a mix of shock and fury. You left home without saying anything. You dare to speak ill about our family? Dabi laughed. Oh, I'm just getting started. Imagine what this could do to your already fragile psyche. Shoto's gaze was fixed on the illusion of Endeavor, his emotions a tempest of confusion and pain. The sight of his father, someone he had longed to impress and gain approval from, stirred something deep within him. As Shoto struggled with the illusion, Dabi took advantage of his distraction. He moved swiftly, striking with precision. Shoto's defenses were down, and Dabi's attacks hit their mark. No, this can't be happening. Shoto's voice cracked with desperation. Dabi's grin was merciless. Oh, but it is. And you're falling for it. Just like old times, huh? With a final, devastating blow, Dabi sent Shoto sprawling to the ground, defeated. The illusion of Endeavor flickered and vanished as Dabi stood over his fallen brother, a mixture of triumph and disdain in his eyes. Bakugo, still struggling to rise, looked at Dabi with a mixture of shock and grudging respect. You, bastard. Dabi's gaze turned to Bakugo. Well, now that the family drama's out of the way, let's get down to business. Midoriya, who had been watching in horror, finally found his voice. What have you done? Dabi's expression softened, but only slightly. Just a little psychological warfare. You should know how it is with family. They always find a way to hurt you, no matter how hard you try. Shoto, defeated but still breathing, looked up at Dabi with a mix of anger and resignation. You're nothing but a twisted version of the person you were meant to be. Dabi shrugged, and you're just the golden boy who couldn't live up to expectations. Funny how things turn out. Bakugo, still standing with visible effort, glared at Dabi. You think you've won? Don't get too cocky. I was supposed to be the one to take that mother fker down. Dabi chuckled, turning his attention back to Midoriya. Well, since I've dealt with the family issues, let's just say we're all square. For now. Midoriya, still shaken, glanced at Shoto. Are you okay? Shoto, struggling to get up, nodded weakly. I'll be fine. Just, let's get out of here. Are you f-king kidding me, Deku? Don't get your feelings mixed up with this reality, idiot. I'm not, Kachan. I just feel bad for Todoroki. Midoriya's eyes widened as he felt a hand grip the hair at the back of his head and pulled him for a forceful kiss. I love you so much, Izuku. I'm willing to forget everything that happened today if you just come home with me once again. Please, choose me, Izuku. Midoriya's face turned red while Bakugo and Dabi's jaws were hung open from what they witnessed. You just stole my first kiss. He felt another lip crashed on his and he was left in shock once again. That's how you kiss, you dang half-en half-bastard. Why are you testing kisses on me? Dabi watched in amusement as he walked towards them. Can I test it out on you too, Izuku? No more, please. Dabi held his chin and smirked. I'm just kidding, darling. Get up and leave those bastards alone. Let them test their kissing techniques on another. Dabi helped Izuku get up from the ground, leaving Shoto and Bakugo grit their teeth in anger. Mother fker, aren't you gonna help me up? Why, you were still strong enough to take advantage of Izuku in that state. Dabi held Midoriya's hand. Midoriya looked back at the two while he was being dragged by Dabi away.
Let's go, Izuku. In Class 2A's location.
Guys, you alive? Where are you?
Oh my god, it's so dark in here.
Kirishima hugged himself as he looked around the dark place. Kirishima's voice echoed through the dark forest, panic evident in his tone. The group had been searching for hours with no sign of Todoroki, and their worry was growing by the minute.
Calm down, Kirishima. We need to stay focused.
Iida instructed, his authoritative demeanor trying to keep everyone in check.
I can't believe this is happening.
Mina muttered, her usually cheerful expression replaced by one of concern.
Where could he have gone?
Siro, using his tape to climb up a tree, tried to get a better view.
I can't see anything from up here.
It's too dark.
Jiro's earphone jacks were extended, trying to pick up any sounds.
I don't hear anything unusual.
Just the usual forest noises.
Kaminari, visibly worried, looked at Iida.
Should we call for backup?
Maybe some of the pro heroes can help.
No, we can't risk drawing attention.
Remember, we have to keep this under wraps until we know more.
As the group continued their search, Uraraka noticed something glinting in the moonlight.
Hey, what's that over there? She pointed to a small, reflective object partially buried in the ground.
They approached cautiously, and Suyu crouched down to examine it.
It looks like a pendant.
It's Todoroki's.
Kirishima's eyes widened. He was definitely here, but where did he go?
The bush rustled as they made their way past it.
Suddenly, a voice called out to them.
Who's there?
Wait, that sounds like.
No way, move and I'll kill ya, bastard.
The same voice called out from the other side, but this time, they saw a glowing light.
We, we're not an enemy.
We're just passing by, kind sir.
Iida responded, though nervousness was evident in his voice.
In Bakugo's location, there was a rustling coming from a few meters.
Bakugo could already sense that there were several demons approaching their location.
He prepared his arrows but later heard a surrendering statement from the other side, trying to avoid conflict.
Bakugo, of course, did not buy such words.
Passing by, who are you kidding, you demon fkers?
Trying to save your king from me.
Ha, better luck next time.
He was about to shoot his arrow when Todoroki spoke next to him.
Ba Bakugo, don't.
Bakugo looked at him. It was the same injured Todoroki, but something feels off with him now.
Something feels right, if he were to rephrase it.
What, bastard, did you call your minions after getting beat up by your own half-n half-brother?
Who would have thought you'd be such a crybaby?
What are you talking about, Bakugo?
Brother, is Natsuo here, too?
Ha, ask that bastard Dabi yourself.
To Tuya, what?
Are you out of your mind now, Bakugo?
Tuya is in the healthcare unit. He was badly injured from the last battle.
Bakugo blinked in confusion.
Injured? He wasn't even scratched.
You're the one who was beat up, bastard.
Could you enlighten me, please?
I seem like I don't remember anything.
Or perhaps you're the one who needed some checkup.
What did you say?
Bakugo was about to land an arrow on Todoroki when demons stepped in.
Bakugo,
Todoroki,
oh my f king god.
Isn't Bakugo in coma in the hospital right now?
Is that his ghost?
Even his ghost never got peace.
For real, the word rip is stranger to him.
Are you Bakugo's imposter?
How dare you copy our friend?
Bakugo was surprised by the situation, but he quickly recovered back into his usual self.
What are you doing here, you idiots?
Now I gotta take care of more idiots from this Todoroki demon king bastard.
Whoa, that's a lot of bastard words.
Is that your favorite word?
I thought it was Izuku.
Kaminari received a handful of yelling because Bakugo can't blast him off in this world.
Why are you even alive, dunce face?
I already hit you in the head to finally shut your face.
Hi loves, I've missed you all, so we're diving into another part in the next video, hahaha. I promise not to bore you with my Dabi-inspired life story.
Membership on my channel is now open. Instead of using expensive and complicated Patreon, I've decided to post special videos exclusively for members here. You can join as a tea enjoyer for $0.99 United States cents or a VIP tea session for $3.99 United States cents. Prices may vary based on your location and inflation.
せーの。でもそんなんじゃダメ。 もうそんなんじゃほら心は進化するよもっともっと。テレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテレテ